In this video, we talk about latches, and in particular the NAND latch. Since computers manage only bits, a memory is something which can remember bits. We'll see how SR NAND latch works and how this simple combination can remember a bit. So, if you are ready, let's go started! Here you are, the SR NAND latch. SR is for set and reset. The latch is composed by two NAND gates, in which the output of one is an input of the other. It has two inputs, set and reset, and two outputs, Q and not Q, which is always the opposite of Q. So, it actually has just an independent output. Before studying the NAND latch working, let's see, once again, the NAND gate operations. This is the NAND gate, and this is its truth table. You can see, if there is a 0 at least in one of the two inputs, the output is 1. The only way to get a 0 on the output is applying 1 to both the inputs. Now we come back to our latch. You have to imagine that the inputs are usually to 1, and we give little pulses to 0. That's why S and R are written with a little dash on the top. We keep input R to 1, and we give a pulse to input S to go to 0. A NAND gate with a 0 in input puts the output to 1, and consequently the second gate, having a 1 in both the inputs, puts the output to 0. You can see Q is 1, and not Q is the opposite, 0. If now we turn back input S to 1, nothing happens. Q keeps the value 1, and not Q keeps the value 0. In a certain way, Q remembers the previous bit. If we now give a 0 pulse to R, the second NAND output turns in 1, and immediately the first NAND, having both the inputs to 1, puts the output Q to 0. So, with a 0 in input R, Q is 0, and not Q is 1. If now input reset switches to 1, we see nothing happens. Q is still 0, and not Q is still 1. In some ways, the circuit remembers the previous value. You saw here that by giving a 0 pulse to input set, output Q goes to 1, and by giving a 0 pulse to input reset, output Q goes to 0. You also saw when both the inputs are 1, the output is kept in the previous value. It could be 0 or 1. It depends on the previous input configuration. Let's see the truth table of the NAND SR latch. The inputs are set and reset, and the output is Q. We leave out not Q because it's always the opposite of Q. If we give a 0 pulse to set, keeping reset to 1, we get 1 on the output. If we give a 0 pulse to reset, keeping set to 1, we get 0 on the output. If we now come back with both the inputs to 1, we can have 1 or 0 on the output depending on the previous situation. In this case, our last pulse was the reset, so we have a 0 on the output. This is how latch remembers a bit. Acting on set and reset, we put a 1 or a 0 to output Q, and we can store it by keeping set and reset to 1. Our default situation is with set and reset both to 1, and we act by giving some 0 pulses to change the output value. So, in the default configuration, the latch stores a bit, and if I want to change the bit stored, I give a 0 pulse to set or to reset. The last input combination is 0, 0. In this case, we should have a 1 in both Q and not Q. But this is true when 0 pulses arrive perfectly synchronized to the inputs, and when they propagate perfectly synchronized, so not in the real cases. Let's see what happens when both inputs are zero, but the pulses are out of phase. In this first case, the set zero pulse arrives after the reset one. So in this case, you can see a train of little pulses arriving in the inputs, and consequently changing the output. But let's go in order. This is our timeline, and we'll see very slowly what happens. We start with 2-1 on the inputs, and so the output keeps its previous value. After a while, a zero reset pulse comes, but not yet the set pulse, so we have just a zero reset pulse situation, and Q is zero. After another while, we have zero to both the inputs, and Q is one. But after another moment, we have a zero pulse on set, and Q turns to one. At the end, the inputs return to 1, thus remembering the last situation. You can see the last situation is a zero pulse in set, so Q remains 1. On the contrary, if set arrives before reset, we have a zero pulse reset before the memory situation, in which inputs are both 1. So output Q this time is 0. In conclusion, the synchronized pulses situation is not a real one, and we cannot know which pulse arrives first and which one propagates faster. For this reason, the 0-0 combination in inputs is an invalid situation. We saw through the latch we can remember a bit, and we can decide which bit remember controlling set and reset, but the latch is not so easy to handle. For this reason, we add two more NAND gates. Let's study this configuration. On the right, we have the latch. On the left, we have a two NAND configuration with two inputs, in and set. Remembering that a NAND gives always one if there is at least a zero in input, we see immediately that if set is zero, regardless of input in, two ones are on the inputs of the latch. So it is in the memory situation and it keeps its previous value. If set is 1, the value of the output depends on input in. Let's study better this configuration with the help of a simulator. I put some probes on the NAND output to show the operations of this circuit. You can see there is a 0 in the bright green lines and a 1 in the dull ones. We start with a 0 in set and a 1 in input in, and as you can see, we have a 1 on the output. But changing the input in to 0, we see nothing happens. So if set is 0, nothing happens on the output, regardless of input in. If we now put set to 1 and in to 0, we see the output become 0. And if we now turn the inputs in to 1, the output turns 1 as well. So if set is 1, the output takes the input value. This is a memory cell much easier to handle, where you can store the input value by controlling set input. This memory cell is called D-latch or data latch. It is much easier to handle in respect to SR latch. Here you can store the input data by controlling set input. This is how you can store a byte using NAND gates. Now we can raise our level of abstraction with our memory symbol. Storing one bit is not enough. You can manage just on and off situation. But by putting side by side our cells and connecting together set inputs, we can have a 8-bit memory cell. Now our cell stores a whole byte, so 256 different combinations, which you can use to encode a lot of things, characters, pixels, etc., etc. This is how you can store a byte using NAND gates.